Thank you for joining this presentation about recent innovations in PVD and PECVD technology for anti-reflective coating manufacturing. The technologies discussed in this presentation have been developed by AGC, and the equipment is manufactured by its new business unit, AGC Plasma Technology Solutions. This presentation will focus on the innovations AGC has developed to support the cost-effective mass production of anti-reflective coatings. Anti-reflective coatings can be found on architectural glass, for example. By reducing the total glass reflection coming from both surfaces from a level of 8% to a level of 1% for a double-sided coated anti-reflective soda lime glass sheet, the glass appears highly transparent and does not reflect its own surroundings. Objects behind the glass are more clearly visible and can be shown off to full effect. Anti-reflective coatings are also used to increase the electrical output of solar panels by putting anti-reflective coating on the solar cell and the cover glass. The anti-reflective coating will increase the amount of light absorbed by the solar cell and hence increase the conversion rate of the photovoltaic module. Anti-reflective coatings are also applied on eyewear to improve vision, reduce eye strain, and make your eyeglasses look more attractive. Other applications include anti-reflective coatings applied on the cover glass of displays to increase the light output. The anti-reflective coating can be combined with an anti-glare treatment of the glass, that is a roughening of the glass surface, for example, by acid etching, prior to the anti-reflective coating being applied in order to obtain the optimal readability of the display. Several types of anti-reflective coatings have been developed over the last decades and can be found in the field, depending on the requirements. There are single-layer coatings, multi-layer coatings, and graded index coatings. The major disadvantage of monolayer anti-reflective coatings is that it reduces reflectance at a specific wavelength only, and the anti-reflective efficiency declines as the angle of light incidence varies from the normal incidence, due to the difference in optical path length at oblique angles relatively to the normal angle. This issue can be solved by fabricating porous nanostructures, by tuning the refractive index of the coating through porosity, or by using multi-layered interferential type of optical coatings. Different fabrication methods and techniques have been used for the preparation of anti-reflective thin films. Organic coatings are applied on polymer substrate and can give an excellent adhesion to the substrate without the need for a high temperature curing cycle. The weakness of the polymer coatings is that they frequently give rise to a poor UV stability and scratch resistance, making them less suitable for outdoor applications. An industrial example of Sol-gel-based anti-reflective coatings can be found for the coating of the cover glass for the solar cells. The precursors can be applied by spray, roll, or dip coating, and are cured and sintered at high temperature. This makes the Sol-gel coatings not suitable for temperature-sensitive substrates. Additionally, the accuracy of the coating thickness with such application methods is much poorer compared to the vacuum thin film coating technologies, so they are most frequently applied as monolayer coatings, limiting their optical performance. The advances in anti-reflective production technology, further explained in this presentation, are developed for the low-pressure plasma coating technologies. Magnetron sputtering allows for wide area coating and is used in the glass industry for coating glass sheets with a standard dimension of 3.2 meter by 6 meter. Certainly for multi-layer interferential anti-reflective coatings, the thickness control of the individual layers is critical for obtaining the desired optical properties. Upgrading the cathodes with an online shimmable magnet bar is a great tool for operators to adjust the layer thickness profile of the deposited layer over the entire width of the coater during the production run. As will be explained in the next slides, the technology also allows coating curved sheets and 3D objects with good uniformity. An important constraint of the magnetron sputtering is the relatively low deposition rate. Using plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition sources will allow for much faster coating deposition, and AGC developed a PECVD source, the PlasmaMax, that can be integrated in an inline low-pressure coater in combination with other sputter cathodes. The design of the source allows for long operation runs without excessive contamination, a problem that can frequently be encountered with other PECVD sources. The proprietary design and working principle of the PlasmaMax source will be explained further on. The PlasmaMax technology gives access to a wide variety of chemistries. AGC did most of the development work on the silicon oxide coating by starting with silene, HMDSO or TMDSO precursor material, but plenty of other development lay ahead for process development with the PlasmaMax source. The ion implantation source is another innovation upscaled by the team of AGC Plasma Technology Solutions. Strictly speaking, ion implantation is not a coating technology, as no additional layer of materials is deposited on the substrate surface. The ion implantation is a surface modification by implanting ions in the substrate surface, which can, in the case of a glass surface, can create a gradient in the refractive index, and hence an anti-reflective surface, or it can put the surface in compression for increasing the scratch resistance of the glass surface. The first innovation that will be discussed in further detail is the online shimmable magnet bar. Coating uniformity is from utmost importance for architectural glass, as the human eye is very sensitive to see any difference in the spectral reflectance of the glass. Hence, the coating production plants have to respect a stringent color box during and between the coating runs to avoid a checkerboard effect after the installation of the glass sheets into the building envelope. Obviously, also other applications requiring superior coating uniformity over large areas can benefit substantially from the use of AGC's online shimmable magnet bar technology. For example, the coating of metal coil for buildings and anti-reflective coatings for solar cell manufacturing, just to mention a few of them. Another potential application of the IOSMB technology is the adjustment of the coating uniformity of curved and 3D surfaces, where it is impossible to maintain the same target surface distance for the complete object. Till now, the main options for coating uniformity control on a large area coater are the introduction of masks between the cathode and the substrate, to use trim gas, allowing profile correction during the production, and third, to locally adjust the magnetic field of the magnet bar of the cathode during the maintenance. Each of the mentioned methods bring, however, a number of inconveniences with them, motivating AGC to work on an alternative option. The introduction of a mask between target and substrate will, for example, reduce the deposition rate, as a certain quantity of the sputter material will stick on the mask. On top of that, This material might peel off later on and fall on the substrate, creating pinholes and defects and jeopardizing the production yield. Most of the experienced PVD manufacturers will therefore avoid the use of masks in their coater and look for alternative solutions. A segmented process gas inlet consists of smaller mass flow controllers and segments of gas tubing which allow gas to be independently delivered to smaller sections of a cathode. These segments are designed to allow the operator to use each segmented gas flow as a means of adjusting the coating uniformity and to trim the thick and thin areas of a coating. The use of trim gases is, however, not so straightforward to use for the operators, as the relationship between the trim gas flow and its influence on the coating thickness will be material dependent, and the trim gases can also influence the coating stoichiometry and refractive index. The adjustment of the magnetic field strength over the width of the cathode is another possibility to locally adjust the plasma density at the target surface and hence to correct for non-uniformities. The magnetic field strength can be measured by means of a magnetic field mapper, and the strength of the magnet segments or yokes can be modified. AGC developed a software to support the maintenance team with such exercises that could take place yearly and can be done with planar as well as rotatable cathodes. Instead of modifying the strength of the magnets, it's also possible to change the distance between the magnets and the target, as shown in the next slide. The inconvenience of this work procedure is that it can only be done during the maintenance, and the uniformity cannot be adjusted during the production run. This can create costly downtime on the installation. In addition, there is a limited accuracy for changing the magnet target distance when it is performed by a manual adjustment with screws. Therefore, the online shimmable magnet bar has been developed by AGC. The IOSMB controls the magnetic field strength distribution in real time during the coating process. Changes to the magnetic field strength distribution are utilized to compensate non-uniformities in the profile of the deposited coating without the need to switch off the plasma or to vent the coater and interrupt the production process. Each individual yoke has a length between 110 mm and 220 mm and can be positioned in height relative to the target surface with motors controlled by integrated electronics. The independent control of each individual yoke enables locally precise control of the magnetic field strength along the entire cathode length. This allows users unprecedented control of coating thickness uniformity on large area substrates and curved objects. The system is fully battery powered and therefore has no electrical connections to the exterior during the operation. An integrated tuning wizard shows the effects of changes to the magnetic yoke settings on the resulting layer profile uniformity to guide the operator in making the right decisions. An easy-to-use graphical interface allows the operator to control the settings of the individual yokes of the IOSMB by graphical sliders. By adopting IOSMB technology, non-uniformities can be limited to 0.3% over the coating width of 3.2 meter for dielectric and metal layers on flat surfaces. So on the slide here, you see the gray curve giving the uniformity before adjustment with the IOSMB and the black curve after the adjustment. Another application of the IOSMB technology is for reducing the tuning time
for complex multi-stack coatings or coatings on complex parts like curved 2D and 3D objects.
The complete specification of the IOSMB can be found on the slide. AGC has equipped most of its magnetron coaters with this technology and is successfully running these components since 5 years. It can be noted that not all cathodes should be upgraded with an IOSMB, as one cathode position per dielectric allows to correct for the non-uniformity introduced by the other cathodes of the dielectric. AGC is also successfully using the technology with rotatable metal targets like silver. The IOSMB technology can be used on vertical and horizontal coaters, and also existing magnetrons can be upgraded with the IOSMB technology even without the need of changing the end blocks. A second multi-year development that is currently industrialized by AGC Plasma is the Plasma Maxsource. This is a high-rate plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition source that can be integrated in a conventional magnetron sputtering line. PECVD is a low-temperature chemical process by which functional thin films are grown on a substrate surface from a gaseous precursor. PECVD provides significant advantages to magnetron sputtering, as the deposition rate can be much higher and the substrate temperature remains low during the deposition process, making it also suitable for polymer film coating. The Plasma Max sources are designed as multiple linear hollow cathodes, which are alternately driven using AC or bipolar pulsed power. Each hollow cathode electrode takes the form of an elongated cavity with multiple gas inputs and an arrangement of gas outputs facing towards the substrate. The process gas is fed into the electrode cavity and is ionized by applying an alternating current or pulsed power with a frequency in the range of 20 to 100 kHz. The ionized process gases will then uniformly exit into the process chamber through a series of holes. By introducing a precursor material through the area in between the multiple linear hollow cathode electrodes, the precursor will decompose in the plasma gas and a uniform thin film can be deposited on substrates in the process chamber. The separation of the plasma generation and precursor inlet avoids the buildup of contamination on the sources and makes these devices particularly useful for long campaign lengths. As many optical coatings contain a thick SiO2 layer, AGC has focused most of the process development work on optical SiO2 coating, starting from several types of precursor material, like silene HMDSO, which means hexamethyldisiloxane, or TMDSO, trimethyldisiloxane. The obtained deposition rates with the Plasma Max source range between 200 to 500 nanometer meter minute, depending on the concentration of allowable residual carbon in the coating. These traces of carbon will make the coating slightly yellowish if above a critical level of 5%, but will also avoid that the coating becomes too brittle to be applied on flexible substrate material like polymer film. Besides SiO2 coatings, there is a very wide range of other coating layers that can be applied by this PECVD technology. AGC is working on TiO2 coatings as well as fluorinated water repellent coatings, just to mention a few other possibilities. we actively engage and support research labs in the private sector and academic world to use the PlasmaMax technology for developing further applications. The main advantages of the technology is that it will be easily upscaled for industrial use for coating large areas up till 3.2 meter width, and it will allow for long coating cycles without the need for opening the vacuum chamber for cleaning and maintenance. A first industrialization of the technology is done on an in-house architectural coater for the production of the ClearSight, which is an anti-reflective glass. The complex coating stack includes several thick SiO2 layers, and by replacing some magnetron cathodes with a PECVD source, the cycle time can be considerably reduced. The uniformity requirements of the individual layers are, however, very stringent, and therefore the PECVD is combined with a magnetron cathode that has been upgraded with an IOSMB. So the bulk of the SiO2 layer is deposited by PECVD, and the remaining non-uniformity is corrected by magnetron sputtering SiO2 from a rotatable cathode. This setup allows for non-stop production campaigns of over a week without debris, even if it can be mentioned that the setup of horizontal top-down deposition makes the process very sensitive to such type of issues. Another example is shown here with the integration of the PlasmaMax source in a roll-to-roll coater. The determining reason for selecting the PECVD source for the deposition of SiO2 is here the low internal stresses induced in the deposited layer. The polymer film is very sensitive to deformation in case these stresses are too important. The possibility to apply the SiO2 at low temperature also allows to avoid any damage of the polymer surface. The ion implantation technology, commercialized under the name Hard Ion Plus by EGC and the partner company Ionics, is the third and last innovation that will be discussed in this presentation. The technology is used in the semiconductor industry for doping with boron since many decades, and the technology is now adopted for treating glass surfaces with nitrogen ions in order to make their surfaces anti-reflective. The ion implantation technology consists in bombarding in a vacuum chamber the surface with highly energetic ions. The ions penetrate violently into the surface of the material, then stop and lose their energy because of a cascade of collisions. The surface reorganization and the implantation of ions into the glass surface will modify the density and porosity at the glass surface. The refractive index gradient caused by this modified surface porosity leads to an anti-reflection surface with excellent angular dependency and no residual absorption. EGC uses the Hard Ion Plus ion gun developed by its partner Ionics. This ion gun is based on the electron cyclotron resonance ECR technology that allows the formation of multi-charged ions thanks to the use of high-frequency microwaves of 10 GHz and strong permanent magnets to confine the plasma. The presence of ions with different charges allows simultaneous ion implantation at different depths. The ECR technology enables EGC to develop ion implantation on an industrial scale, thanks to the high ion current of 1 to 8 mA, making high dose up till 10 to the 17th ions per square centimeter on large surfaces feasible. The treatment of soda lime float glass is shown in the figure above. It can be seen that compared to a reference glass given 8% reflection from both surfaces, the reflection can be reduced to a residual reflection of 5% by treating one side of the glass. This means that the reflection of the treated surface is reduced from 4% till 1%, and that a residual reflection of 2% is feasible by doing the ion implantation on both sides of the surface. The upscaling of the technology is currently ongoing at AGC. The maximum size that has been treated is a dimension of 1.6 meter by 1.8 meter and is treated with a good uniformity with a vacuum installation including 5 hard ion plus heads. Should an application be identified requiring bigger glass dimensions, AGC is confident that the installation can be smoothly upscaled till a dimension of 3.2 meter by 6 meter. The ion implantation technology is successfully used for the treatment of acid edge glass. Acid edge glasses, also called anti-glare glasses, are glasses with an increased surface roughness. For applications like curved automotive display panels, outdoor touch panels and e-readers, which are subject to dynamic sunlight conditions, it is critical that users always have a clear view of the display. The increased surface roughness will reduce the glare of the screen by making the reflection more diffuse and so less distractive for the observer. On top of that, the increased surface roughness will create a paper-like feeling when touching the glass surface, making the customer experience more enjoyable. The readability of displays can be further improved by the application of an anti-reflective coating, given a higher light transmittance and better contrast of the image. However, due to the rough glass surface, it's very troublesome to design an adequate anti-reflective thin film coating that attains a minimal reflectance from all viewing angles and for a broad range of wavelengths. The anti-reflective coatings realized by adding a multi-layer stack on top of the acid edged glass will frequently have a purple reflection and show a poor angular dependency. The anti-reflective treatment by ion implantation solves this issue, as no additional layer is added on the substrate. In addition, the ion implantation can be performed before and after the chemical tempering, resulting in an increased flexibility in the supply chain. The ion implantation treatment can be combined with the application of fluorinated anti-smudge coating by PECVD process that can be integrated in the same vacuum machine. In conclusion, let me summarize that AGC has a long experience of applying optical coatings on glass surfaces by low-pressure coating technology. The coating equipment used to perform these operations are designed and constructed in Germany since more than 4 decades. With the launch of the new business unit, AGC Plasma Technology Solutions, AGC is now offering tailor-made coating equipment for customers outside the AGC group, and we offer them support to operate these lines at the lowest cost of ownership. AGC Plasma is also continuously working on further improving of the technology, and 3 important improvements are discussed in this presentation. First, the online shimmable magnet bar has been discussed. It is a flexible tool to correct the coating thickness during the sputtering process without the need to go to atmospheric conditions. Second, the plasma max source has been discussed, a high-rate PECVD source for depositing thick SiO2 layers at low temperatures with minimal internal stresses, this source opens huge possibilities for the deposition of other oxides and nitrides by changing the precursor material and process gases. Third, the ion implantation technology for making anti-reflective treatment of glass surfaces with superior angular stability and no additional absorption has been explained. With this, I want to thank you for your attention and please do not hesitate to contact AGC Plasma with additional questions or any further inquiry. Take care.